Perfect. Hello everyone, I am Cyclohexane, and today I'm going to play a game I've never played before, Wipeout 3. I've played the original, I've played 2097, which is my favorite, but I've not played this one. I've also played the Nintendo 64 version, but for some reason, I have never touched the third installment in the series. So this is a special edition, it contains new tracks as well as old ones. So we will get a nice variety of stages. So seeing as I've never played this game, I see that there's a challenge mode and a tournament mode. I imagine that the tournament mode is the usual type of several races in a row, and you have to not necessarily win, but place highest in general standings. So we will try that first, and I have Vector, Venom, and Rapier right off the bat. So we'll start with Vector, obviously, and the first thing I notice when I open this game is there are four ship makes as usual. However, we've got a bit of a new one here. Actually, we've got two new ones. If you remember back in 2097, we had Fysar, who are still there, and Oricom, who were still there. But we also had AG Systems, who are decidedly not here, and Kyrex, who are also decidedly not here. Instead, it's Piranha Advancements, which sort of were in 2097, and Goteki 45, which is a brand new ship, a brand new make for this game. So the stats have also evolved. As always, Fysar... Actually, no. I always struggle to read those stats. But yeah, Fysar is the slowest. Has really good acceleration, and then shield and handling is pretty good. Goteki 45 is actually quite balanced, but still pretty slow. Oricom, as always, is extremely balanced and has all stats of 3. And we've got Piranha Advancements, who is pretty slow. It doesn't have that many shields, but handles pretty well and has good top speed. So knowing all that, I would assume that in terms of similarities to previous games, Piranha Advancements is closest to AG Systems, so that's the one I will pick for now. So we start with the very first race, and I didn't even check what it was called. And this is all completely new to me, of course. Oh, right, I didn't set up the buttons, I might... There we go. Okay, so it's reversed from my usual controls when it comes to using items and dropping them, so that's fine. Other than that, it doesn't control too differently from 2097 from now, or at least for now, but we have to see. Looks like the game doesn't tell you what kind of projectiles are being fired at you, it just gives you a warning. And this time you actually have the intercom telling you what kind of weapon you're picking up, which is nice. Seeing as this is Vector, these races look quite easy. You do get in this game an indicator of where the pit lane is, which is nice. But yeah, there we go. Round 2 at Mega Mall. Okay, let's get it going. So these races, obviously, Vector class, these are going to be done very quickly. And we're going to progressively ramp up until we unlock all the good stuff. I'm not sure how to get the fast start in this game if you do have a fast start. Again, that is something I guess I'll experiment with. There we go. So you get two missiles in this version instead of just the one. So the Force Wall was actually a special weapon for Kyrex in Wipeout 64. So that's interesting seeing it brought back here. And same for the energy drain, which was extremely busted and also AG System's special weapon in that game. So again, sort of interesting to see old weapons make a comeback. We already were into the only the second race in the entire game. Oh, there we go. There's the autopilot. All right. And already it's much more complex than the first one, and I'm bumping into walls a lot more. And it should do it. Oh, actually, no, that's not the start line. I saw the pit lane, I got confused. Much longer race than the first one. That should be it, though. Yep, all good. So this first tournament, I believe, is only four races long, so should be done with in a relatively quick manner. It doesn't seem like getting this fast start business done right, if there is something like that. Hang on to those missiles until I catch up to the others. There we go. Ah! It's unfortunate. I wanted to avoid that as much as I could. Oof, that was an enemy I couldn't really, wall I couldn't really see. So this is a reflector, I believe, which is different from the shield. Oh, that was the quake. And yeah, the bumping into enemies business is not doing me any favor right now. I probably need to get a move on. Force wall again. Oh boy, already final lap. I've got some racing to do here. It's not gonna work too well if I keep bumping against opponents. There we go. So that's the autopilot. I do believe I was hit by something. Oh, there's the invisibility. That was Pyrona 2. Sorry, Pyrona. That was Piranha 2's special weapon in 64. So again, that's another weapon making a comeback in this game. Alright, and there you have it. So we should have one more. Yeah, Stanza Inter should be the last race. And apparently Stanza Inter is where the game starts picking up in terms of track difficulty. So looking forward to seeing that. Okay, I'll take the missiles. Yeah, it's definitely not as easy all of a sudden. Very sudden turns. And again, I completely bump into the back of the opponent I hit. That seems to be a staple of mine. Quake will help. But mines won't, though, unfortunately. Got a bit of an autopilot. That'd be nice to use at some point. Here, for example, let's see. Not bad, not bad. But that's also a pretty short lap. There we go, that's a bit better like this. Of course, I'm sure that tunnel will be a lot harder to negotiate in faster classes, but right now, Vector, I'm taking advantage of the class just to discover all the tracks and see how they drive. Alright! Well, that should be the... yep. That's the first tournament done with. And something that will be interesting is I also have access to Classic League, which is a bundle of races from the first Wipeout and 2097. So we've got it right here. Talon's Reach from 2097, Ultima 7 from the original, Sagarmatha from 2097, and Phoenicia Park also from 2097. I'm gonna stick with Piranha because I've enjoyed how it controls so far. Alright, Talon's Reach. Let's see how updated it is. Let's see, the billboards have been changed. Oopsie. Thought I could get that item right there. Autopilot on Talon's Reach is not the greatest item, but we will take it regardless. There we get a force wall as well. Let's not bump the wall. There we go. And not bad. First place at the end of the lap. And so far, I have to say, I am quite enjoying this. Of course, there's the whole graphical overhaul thing, but generally, this plays pretty similar to the old game, so I will not complain. Though I will say that the game does feel faster even on Vector, which is a good thing. But it is also scary because when we get to Phantom, I am I'm a bit worried for what may happen. But we will see. We will see. Vector was really slow in the in 2097 anyway. So okay, so that should be Ultima 7. Now, the original Wipeout I have played. I'm not a big fan due to the awkward control in that game, but I have played through it and played every single race in it. I've never finished the Rapier tournament in that game because some of the later stages are a bit too crazy for my taste in terms of difficulty, especially with, as I said, the weird controls. That's not really my thing, but I do at least somewhat know the track's outlines. I got attacked by missiles here, I believe. Piranha, you should not be attacking me. We're on the same team. Well, for the time being, I will grab my shield. That's right, they've added a pit lane to these tracks. In the first Wipeout, there was no pit lane because there was no health gestion. Your ships simply couldn't be taken out. The game has added a pit lane in this version. Anyway, taking first place, so this should be smooth sailing here all the way home. Interesting that they've kept some of those billboards up to, they've not changed them any. Well, they've changed some of them, but you see here right there, the 5-star logo is the same as in the first game. So that's interesting how they've kept some of the billboards period correct. And they've also kept the Wipeout 1 trend of making some sections of track ridiculously narrow. Alright. So round 3 of Sagarmatha. This is one I should know pretty well, obviously, from the 2097 streams. I suppose there's nothing for it. Just charge the thrust bar all the way. Sagarmatha looks a lot different, actually. Did it actually go through? I'm not sure. Oh wow, this tunnel, you used to not really be able to see anything, and now it's crystal clear. Very weird. And this is the old Piranha billboard right there. So very, very interesting how they've kept... They've upgraded some billboards and some they haven't touched. Very interesting. Oh boy, I'm getting a pounding back there. Got another pilot here, let's use that. So in this game, it looks like the force wall is sent on the same side of the wall you are on, which I believe is different from the original in Wipeout 64, where it would be put on the opposite side. Alright, and let's close things out with Phoenicia Park. No, this also looks way different, obviously. Phoenicia Park used to be incredibly orange, and this game, it's the color scheme seems to be a lot different. Right, let's not confuse. Let's not get our buttons confused here. Is it just me, or do you get just a lot more weapons in this version, or is it, am I just picking up a lot more weapons than I am used to? This may be due to me playing on Vector class. Good thing I had my shield. Finisher Park, you're not used to playing Finisher Park on Vector. This is very peaceful. But it is nice to be able to replay some of these old tracks from a different era. Especially the ones from the first Wipeout, because the definitely plays different now. Gonna round it up. Pretty nice. Definitely enjoyed that. So far, obviously, Vector class, the game hasn't really given much resistance. Let's see. There are some challenge modes as well, which I will try out. Let's see, challenge one. Vector class, Porto Cora with Fysar. Fair enough. Let's try it out. So I reckon this is similar to the challenges in Wipeout 64, which I did enjoy, even if I'm still very much scarred by Super Challenge 5 from the N64. So we do have 12 contenders here. It's a bit different from what we're used to here. Let's see. That went well. Looking for first place. That's a good double hit. Oh, the cloak does not protect you from impacts. That is good to know. The old game, it would. So I assume they've nerfed it a bit. Okay, so I've reached first place, so we're looking to be in good shape here. Alright, that went really well, but then again, these are the first challenges. Let's see, Vector class, Mega Mall with Goteki 45. Yeah, sure, let's try it. Hey, that's a song I know. Pretty much the only song I know from this game. Control. And let's try out this Goteki 45 ship. It's actually a lot more nimble than I thought it would be. You know, because it really doesn't look nimble at all from the design of the ship. Looks a bit like a brick. fifth place, looking into second lap soon. There we go. Ah, damn it. Bumped into... Not sure what this ship is, I haven't seen it yet. It doesn't look like one of the ships I've unlocked. Well, I've not unlocked any, but... It doesn't look like any of the standard ships, is what I mean. Alright, we've got some time to make up here. There we go. Oh, that's a lot of mines. Thank you for that. Took that out of the pallet. I'll also take that force wall. Okay, we should be doing pretty well here. Nice! Nice, nice, nice. What do we have next? Venom class, Semperon, Oricom Industries. So I'm gonna hold off on that. Let's see, yeah, exit game. I think what I'll do is do the tournaments in their respective classes first and then tackle the challenges. There we go. So this is a time trial challenge, so this is probably going to take me a few attempts, just because if it's like in 64, these are actually pretty tight, but we'll see. So this is what the fights are, so I guess I'm curious to see what the time requirements are. That boost, that's unfortunate. I missed those too. Want to make sure you grab as many boost pads as you can. Okay, let's see. Oh, you gotta go on. You get two laps of these. Okay. Kind of interesting. That's not how it used to be, but I guess we'll see. That wasn't too bad. This is going to be a pretty good lap. This is going to be sub-minute. Well, silver. Let's see. What's the time requirement here? White belt, time challenge. Challenge 1. Sub 2 minutes total. Okay. I can try to do that. Although I would benefit from the fast start strategy here, if it does exist. Let me actually pause for a minute and see if that's actually a thing. Let's see here. Okay, apparently it's the timing thing, which is Not what I'm used to from the Wipeout series, but let's see. No, that was not quite it. I guess we'll try without putting any gas and see how that goes. Maybe a video would be more useful, but I guess we'll see. Nah, I'm not gonna get it without watching a video, so let's see.
Wipeout 3.
There we go. Huh. Okay, let's retry that. Let's retry that. Curious, very curious. Nope, didn't get there. There we go! Just had to finagle with it a little bit. So yeah, the timing definitely feels different compared to the previous game. Now, of course, these time trial challenges are a bit more difficult here because you do have to go through two laps. And the original, you only had to go through one. So that was... I don't know if that's going to be good enough, but we'll see. I do have to get under 2 minutes total time. Is gonna be close. Whoa, oh my god. 159.96. I was not sure I was gonna be fine with that first lap, but it ended up working out. Good lord. That was a close one. Man. I wasn't ready for that. Alright, very nice. But yeah, as always, these time trial challenges, they're pretty difficult. Alright, this is still Vector, Sumparun with Goteki 45. Let's try it out. Oopsie. Let's try that again. Ah, I believe I'm not letting the I'm putting the gauge a bit too low. Oh god, this is really specific, isn't it? It's gonna be hell to do on Vector. There we go. Ooh, that's not gonna be good. bit late on that. Nice. And I do believe that it gets gradually easier as you move up class to gauge these. So. Vector is the worst it'll be. Right-hander right there, nice. Nicely done. Ooh, that's a tight right-hander there. Might need some air brakes to get through there without losing that much speed. It's also a tight one. Let's see, 1 minute. 1 minute one. Let's see if we can do a really good second lap and finish under 2 minutes. Oopsie. Missed the boost, that's not gonna help. Oh nope, that's a restart. That it is. Tried to hug the apex a little too much there. Okay, maybe this is not gonna be so bad. Okay, yeah, this turn is not actually that tight. This one, though, yeah, a bit tighter. Some air brakes help. And this one should be tight also, yeah. Could have done better there. My line wasn't perfectly good. Actually, this is a slower lap than my first attempt. I did miss, I believe, a few turbo strips, so it's not too surprising, but let's see. Second lap might still be good. Time trial challenges are always the hardest to get a gold on, but they're, for me, some of the most fun to just try and retry. There we go, that was pretty good. So yeah, I'm not gonna get under 2 minutes on this one. Okay, that second lap was pretty good, though. If I can do two laps like this, then I should be able to grab it. Okay. Obviously, first lap is always going to be a bit slower due to the start, even with a fast start. So I do have to keep that in mind. Here. Oof. Took to point the nose down, ended up turning. That's not really what I wanted. Okay, that's a good turn though. 1 minute it's just above 1 minute one. So this next lap has to be pretty much perfect. Let's see how we can do. Good. Okay, that was fast through there, very nice. Let's see, 6, 7, I should be able to get this. That was a really good lap. Nice, very nice. 159.68. Alright. That was good. I'm definitely happy with that. Next one is on Venom, so we'll hold that for later. Nice. I'm happy with that. Okay, weapon challenge. 3 eliminations in Porto Cora with Fysar. No need to go too fast here, obviously. We're not looking to necessarily end the race in first. Oh, damn it, I meant to ditch that. Wrong button, of course. There we go. Alright, come on, give me some stuff to actually attack with. There we go. I might go into the options and see if I can change the controls because I'm getting confused here. Gonna need a bit better luck with the hang on, can I actually, I'll go to the, come on, I'll go to the options and fix that controller thing. No, that's not what I want. Options, controller setup, there we go. So this should be fire weapon, this should be drop weapon, yes. Oops. Weapon challenge. Challenge 1. Here we go. Okay. So let's hope that we get better weapons here. Because I'm not going to do much with just cloaks and shields and autopilots. Wait. Did it not save? Hang on. Hang on. That was odd. Controller setup. Yeah, I told you this button. If I go back in. Okay, that is proper. Oh, also I should save. Wow, takes a while to save. Alright. Alright, let's try that again. Let's see here. Can we get some real weapons? No, we cannot. Come on, man. Oh my god. I should stay on the right here. Yep, again. Please stop. Oh my god. I wonder if this happens regularly. Okay, here we go. So that's one of them. Actually managed to get one elimination. Getting a lot of quakes. Okay, that's the second one. Thanks for the mines. Let's hang on to this. Oh, goddammit. I was gonna say let's hang on to this quake for now, but Womping there wasn't in my best interest. Anyone in front? There we go. That's not what I need. Ah. It's gonna be it, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. Well, we'll retry it. You do get an annoying amount of weapons you just don't need on this mode, apparently. I think that's supposed to be part of the challenge, is that most of the weapons you get aren't actually damaging to the other pilots. But I suppose we will see. There we go. And of course, out of muscle memory, I ditch it. Well done, me. Alright, come on. That. Don't want that either. Nope. Still don't want that. There we go. I need to get ahead, but I can do that. Okay, one down. Get these guys in front. Okay, two. Ooh, nice. That's four of them. Okay, that's all I need. Let's bring the ship home, and we're in good pace. So yeah, I guess the difficulty there was just not get the all the gigantic amount of defensive weapons that you have access to. Which, fair enough. There we go. And next challenge, we've got Vector Class, Samparan, Goteki 45, also 3 eliminations. Okay. Would be mines are nice, but they're even better when I'm in front. Fortunately, that's Goteki 45. That's it's high armor I'm going up against here. Hey, come on. Oh, he had a reflector. That's unfortunate. Try that again. Ooh, nice. Okay, one down. I'm not gonna waste time on Goteki 45, that seems like a fool's errand. Oh, I got a reflector anyway. Couldn't see it. Ooh. Actually. Slow down a bit. Come on. Where are you? Taking his sweet time, I suppose. Oh, he went through the pit lane. I'm a dumbass. Yeah. Yeah, of course he'd go through the lane. What was I thinking? Alright. Rockets are nice. Need to get closer, though. To, and that's, yep, that's a shield. Reflector could be nice. I don't want that. Ah, damn it, that wasn't my kill. Okay, one down. Ah, let's go take E45. Let's not waste our time with that. Ooh, I'm pretty slow. I'm pretty low on time. Let's, all has to be here. Okay, where are the opponents? There we go. Nice. Wow, that was lucky. I'll take that though. Just need to finish in time. And we are good. Gold medal. Very sweet. Alright, now we do the same, but with the Classic League. So we've got Vector Class, Talons Reach, Fysar, fair enough. This shouldn't pose too many problems, obviously, since by this point I am quite trained in going through Talon's Reach on Phantom, so doing it on Vector really shouldn't be any troubles. A bit. That wasn't very smart of me. Get out the way, Goteki. First place. Alright, we should have this. I forgot I've got the hyper thrust in this game to make me go faster at the cost of some health. And let's see. Vector class, Ultima 7 with Goteki 45. Sure! Sure, sure, sure. Hoping I wouldn't bump against Fysar there, but that's fair enough. There we go. Nicely moving through the field. That's a reflector. I don't want to shoot when there's that in the way. And of course, yep, here we go. Bumping into Fysar again. Ooh, mines. Take the Quake as well. To stop bumping into every single Fysar ship I see in this race. That's no fun. That's first place, I do believe, so only one lap left. Ultima 7 is a pretty chill track, all things considered, so we should be fine here. It is definitely the easiest track of the original. I don't need to shield them sufficiently far ahead. Just need to bring the car home at this point, or the ship home as it would be. It's See if I can nail that last section, because I've not done very well there so far. This tunnel here, where the road gets a lot more tighter. There we go. That's a bit better, isn't it? I'll take that. And next is on Venom class, so we'll do that later. Alright, next we've got the time trial challenges. Ultima 7 with Fysar. 245. Alright. Good start. So 245, and I need to remember that I have access, or I should have access, to Hyper Thruster. To weave in and out to catch all the boost pads there, because you can get some really good speed here. Okay, 1 minute. We did a 2:45, so that's about 2:22 a lap. A 1:22 a lap. Okay, I am on pace. See us through, though. Let's see if that was a wise decision. That's a good turnout after, though. End of the track. Let's not miss this boost pad. That would be tragic. Over here. And through the last turn. And let's get the Hyper Thruster. And yeah, easy. Easy 2:41. So 1:15 on Talon's Reach as Goteki 45. Okay. So 1:15. Let's see. That means about 37 seconds per lap, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, I missed that. There we go. Oh, I missed the first boost, but we'll try it anyway. So they've definitely given me the two easiest races in the old Wipeouts to do a time trial on. Talon's Reach and Ultima 7 are definitely the easiest. So I need 37 on the lap. I'm a bit slow. Actually, yeah, that needs to be faster. We'll see. We'll keep this going regardless, but Just barely didn't make it. Okay, that was a really crummy first lap. Let's retry that. If I can get my shit together on the first lap, this should be doable. And, yeah, I discounted. Alright, try that again. There we go. Let's get a bit more meat speed. So, I mean, this track, it's all about remembering the position of the boost strips. And going from there. That's not bad, actually, so far. Yeah, that is much better. So I did a low 38, which is a bit more than what I need to do, but I do have my hyper thruster. Still, it looked difficult for me to improve on a lap like that. Not sure what I could have done more. Nope, missed this boost. Again, we're gonna rely on the hyper thruster here. Okay, no problem. Definitely doable with the hyper thruster. Next is Venom, so we'll hold that off for now. And we'll do the weapon challenges. And then I think I'll be done for today. Sagarmatha with Goteki 45, and I'm looking for 3 eliminations. Okay. There we go. That's a good start. Ooh. Good weapon right off the bat. Ooh, plasma. That was a kill. Very nice. Actually, the energy drain is not doing much for me at the moment. That was a reflector, not a force wall. Tend to get the icons confused. Come on, move out the way, Piranha. Stop nicking my items. Ooh, plasma. Very nice. That's already 2 of them. So let me slow down so Piranha can pass me. Oh, another plasma, actually, if I hit this. There we go. Alright, just need to finish up. That was nice. Why couldn't I get this many plasmas in the last challenges I did? The weapon challenges. Alright! Very nice. Next one is on Terramax with Faisar and 3 eliminations. So Terramax is actually a race I don't think we've seen yet. Right. It's from the original. So that's interesting at least. It's a new race. Hey, there we go. That's a weapon worth keeping. It's potentially a pre-kill. If I can hit it. And I can hit it. Well, that might not be so bad if I can get a energy drain. Hey, look at that. Unfortunately, that was on Goteki 45. Come on. I didn't want that cloak. I believe that's two Kyrex, so not really any point in trying to take those down. That was poorly played. Yeah, that was a poor effort. That's another Goteki. I'm not getting any good weak targets here. Oh, that's two eliminations. Ah, goddammit, that's the finish line, isn't it? Okay, gonna have to redo that one. Got a plasma early on, but couldn't get any other. And yeah, all the ships seem like they have pretty high... what do you call it? Looks like they have pretty high shields. So. Ah shit, had a reflector. I should have noticed. Ooh, plasma. Okay, that guy has a shield, so let's wait for that to expire. Very nice. That's already two eliminations. Ah. Okay, plasma. That's all I needed. Let's get close. And goodbye, Faisar. Alright, just need to finish the race now. It's another plasma. Another plasma. I'm not even really trying at this point. Nice. I might actually take first here. Ah, damn it. Bumped into it. Hey, first place. Not that it mattered, but hey, that was fun. So is that all the Venom challenges? Yes, it is. Okay. That was nice. Let's see, tournaments. So yeah, that's very nice. And then, so how many new? Okay, let's see. Sampa runs Tanza Inter, Haifumi, Pimar Project. Classic League, we get Sagarmatha, Phoenicia Park, Terramax, and Guard Europa. Yeah, you know what? There's still some time. I'll do the tournaments. Yeah, I'll stick with Piranha for now. Oh yeah, definitely. That's much easier to gauge now. Okay, yep, it's definitely gotten faster. Ooh, I'm already in first place. Okay, well, that was at least quick. That was a good shield, right in the nick of time. I think this is only Venom. This feels like Rapier, I'm not gonna lie. Hang on. Did I get internet issues? Doesn't look like it. Hmm. Weird. Weird. Chat is like, hey, you disconnected. And I'm like, no, I didn't. Oh, yeah, whatever. Or Chatterino, rather, is saying that. No one in chat is saying that. But yeah, whatever. Let's keep going. Man, reaching Rapier with those speeds, that's gonna be fun. And then Phantom. Yeah, it's gonna be terrible, isn't it? We'll see, I suppose. That's good. But to be fair, I am curious as to exactly how quick you can overtake the whole pack in this game, because that didn't take very long. Ow. Okay. And that should be Sephiron. Very nice. Round 2 is Stanza Inter. Oh man, that tunnel as Stanza Inter is going to be interesting. We'll see how well I can perform there. Okay, good. Ooh, that's a, yep. It's a hefty turn. I wasn't expecting that. I've not played Stanza Inter very much. Yep, that's no good. Let's try to salvage this race as much as we can. I do have 3 laps to make it count. To be honest, it's a bit late. There we go, that was a bit cleaner. That was a lot cleaner, in fact. I'm all up to second. Yeah, this track is just a lot of right angle turns. I didn't notice how low my health was getting, so I need to watch out for that. I say as I bump into every wall in the game, of course, but. Lap anyway, I'm in front, I can take it easy. Okay, made it through with barely any health. Haifumi is next, and now we're getting into the races that I haven't played at all, so this is getting a bit interesting, isn't it? 3, 2, not a good idea this. Damn it. Ooh, autopilot. That was a very tight section of track, so I'm glad I got an autopilot to compensate. Okay, they're all here. Very nice. More mines. So yeah, you can definitely get up the pack quickly in this version. That's definitely not something you could have done in the previous wipeout. You really need to claw your way back in that one. Ooh yeah, that's a really tight section. Also a pretty tough turn right there, you need to anticipate that a lot. Starting to come to terms with this track slightly. It was a bit better, unfortunately I bonked on the entry. Yeah, sure, whatever. Okay! PMR Project is next, and that's the last race, but I should be able to win regardless. With 3 wins, it should be enough. We'll see. PMR Project. 3, 2, 1, go! Damn it. Ooh, plasma. Out of my way, SA guy. Oh, yeah, I was supposed to not know the name of that ship, never mind. Pretend I didn't say anything. Ooh, god, I was not ready for the chicane. And of course I engaged the autopilot on a straight line, well done me. Nice. I like this track. I can already tell. Ah, did it a bit too late there. Yes! Now that's what I like! Oh, that was fun! Hmm. Damn it. Crap, come on. I need to be driving better than that. I suppose that will do the trick for now. Now. Yeah, it's a poor third lap I'm putting together there. I'm in first place, so I don't need to try necessarily, but it would still be nice to, you know, do a proper lap here. Plus I'm pretty low on health, but the end's right there anyway. Okay. There you go. So do I unlock anything for doing that? Doesn't appear that way. At least I didn't get a message. We'll try the classic... the classic League Venom class too. Give that a shot. And we start at Sagarmatha. Oh, this is definitely faster than Venom was in 2097. This definitely faster. Okay, in the first place we go. Just barely. Never mind, that's the guy who got in the way. Again, I'm not supposed to know the name of that shit, but whatever. Put me through the pits. No, you're not. So the autopilot AI has definitely changed, because it used to always put you through the pits. It's a lot of autopilots I've been picking up this race. Alright, that'll do it. Easy enough. Let's see, is that Terramax? It looks like Terramax. Oh wait, no, that's Finisher Park. Good dodge. Oh, cloak. Or not, I'm not sure. Poor. Not happy about that. I'm fine with bumping walls generally, but not on Finisher Park and on fucking Venom. Like, come on now. Goodbye. Right, let's make a shot for it. Come on. Let's see the rest of the race through. Very nice. There we go. Okay, I think next is Terramax. Should be. Yeah, looks like it. I know I said that about Phoenicia Park, but I was not thinking. Yeah, this is Terramax. Hey, everyone have a quake. Ah, thought I'd get away with that. Oh, come on. I don't know where to use that. Okay, very nice. Okay, another autopilot. That's what I want. Alright, that should be a pretty simple Terramax. And now we move on to one of my favorite tracks in the franchise, Guard Europa. I'm glad that one's back. Oh wow, and it looks like you can actually see this time around. Things are not completely pitch black. Very new. And I'm immediately in first place. That was quick. Alright, keep it going. That for a bit later. And one last lap. Hey, that was actually a perfect lap. Nice. That was an interesting recovery. Scared myself for a second there. And there we go. That race is as fun as always. As fun as ever would be the proper idiom there. But yeah. That was fun. Let me save before I leave you guys to it. But I enjoyed that. I want to come back to this. Maybe later on. Yes. Yeah, definitely expectations were met, I will say. Anyway, that is going to be it for me. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you next time for more Wipeout 3. I'll tackle the Venom challenges and possibly the Rapier tournaments as well.